Yesterday last topic, error handling, handling expected and unexpected errors. When we get expected errors, whenever we use invalid inputs, then we can expect errors. Why we need to enter invalid inputs? For negative testing. Next, unexpected errors. We discussed some scenarios for unexpected errors. Resource insufficient. Next, resource response. Next, availability of resource, etc. See, for handling errors, we have VBScript features as well as UFT tool feature recovery scenarios. See, first, using conditional statements. Observe. See login functionality. Observe Surasri, run the script. Executing. Next. Once again run the script. Problem. What is the problem Surasri identify?
Sir, already the login window exists.
Login dialog already exists. Once again, it is launching one more login. Two instances of application. So, UFT, confusing. See, how to handle this type of situation? Using conditional statements. Negative condition. If, already we discussed this usage. If not so-and-so dialogue, if not dialogue of login dot exist of suppose 3 seconds, see, observe this structure. If not so and so dialogue exists, then launch the dialogue and continue login operation. Suppose if exists, don't launch, just continue login operation. See, first scenario, no login dialogue exists on desktop. Run the script, checking the existence and launching login. Next, login dialog already exists. It won't launch again, it will continue. Run the script. Next, observe verification, insert verification point. First, generate that window statement also. If so and so window exists, here enter some time, it takes some time for login. Then after checking the existence, close that window. Next, return the result. Example, login successful. Passed. Else failed. Login unsuccessful. See, failed time, it launches error pop-up. It shows error pop-up. We need to close this error pop-up and cancel the login dialog in order to set base date. Here, enter one more conditional structure. In else part, say if so and so error pop up exists, then click on that default button. Cancel the login dialog. See, first time valid input. Run the script. Next time, invalid input. Run the script. See, it waits 12 seconds. After 12 seconds, it will go to else part. In the else part, error handling already there. Over. Observe Nagesh. In this script, three conditions. See, first condition structure for error handling. Second condition structure for
is also error handling.
Error handling.
I mean, login confirmation, sir.
Surasri, the selected one. Second condition structure for verification point.
Sir,
concentrate.
Sir, no, I got it, sir, what you are saying, that it is for verification point, I got that. No, my question was something else, sir. Like for, this is a pop-up window that we got, right, which was an error message, and you recorded the statement, correct? But even when you record it, it still shows that flight reservation exit. I mean, if you see just superficially without knowing the objects, it looks like, you know, it is a flight reservation window. But that is not the case, right? It is an error pop-up.
What is your question? Tell me in simple words.
Sir, yes, sir. See, First, you check if the dialog box exists or not. Mm. And if the login window exists or not, okay, then you wrote the conditional statement that if it already exists, then don't open. Mm. If it doesn't exist, then open the login window. Right? That was the first part.
Okay.
Now, in the second part, you are putting the invalid input, correct?
Mm.
And we got a error pop-up. Correct?
Mm.
The agent name must be 4.
Mm.
But that error pop-up message, that is also a window, which is a site reservation window. Because if we see...
These are not windows, first of all. Login is dialog, flight reservations are also dialog. Child dialog, parent dialog.
What I was saying is that if window flight reservation dot exists, but this flight reservation window and the other flight reservation window,
First of all, this flight it is not flight reservation, reservations, yes is there, observe.
Oh yeah, correct.
See, lot of difference is there. Observe. See, this object is window. This object is dialog. Next, this object name is flight reservation. Next, this object name is flight reservations. Hello?
Yes, sir, got it.
Difference is there. Then what is the problem?
No, I didn't realize the difference, sir. I mean, I was just looking at that flight reservation, that text, and I thought is showing the same text.
No, flight reservations, yes, is there. And one more thing, this object hierarchy is different, that object hierarchy is different. And one more thing,
sir.
Observe here. In this login dialog, OK button is there, na?
Yes, sir.
And one more thing, observe. In this open order also, OK button is there, na?
Yes, sir.
Observe, both are same in size also. Label same, size same. But difference is there. What is the difference? That OK button, see, observe, this right side OK button parent is login dialog. This left side OK button parent is open order dialog. And grandparent is flight reservation window. Difference is there, na?
Yes, sir.
Okay. See, observe. This selected second one, condition statement for verification point. Next, observe Nagesh. Third one. This one?
Error handling.
See, in the script we inserted 3 conditional statements. First one for error handling, second one for verification point, last one for error handling. Already we discussed usage of conditional statements in UFT test automation. Error handling, primary thing is to insert verification points, next error handling. Still confusion, Surasri? Clarified?
No, sir.
Okay.
No, I got it.
Okay.
Thank you.
Welcome. See. See, we covered using conditional statements. Next, exist statement I will discuss. Before that, using built-in functions. See, using some built-in functions also, we can handle errors. See, dim num1 num2 num1 equal to read data using input devices. Muhammad, how to read data using input devices?
So we need to add the same input box of.
Yes, input box, built-in function. Input box of any message. Enter num1. Next, num2. Num2 equal to enter num2. Next, MSG box addition. Addition of num1 comma num2 is concatenate num1 plus num2. Observe num1 10, num2 20. See, my expected output 30, but it is showing 1020. Why? What is the problem? Tell me, Parvin. Parvin, tell me, what is the problem? Why it is showing incorrect output? Parvin, Varalakshmi. Varalakshmi, can you tell me? Hello? You tell me, Mohammed.
Input box is a reading, so first time it's a string type data, so first we need to convert this.
Yes. Say reading time VBScript considers data as string type data. In order to perform mathematical calculations, we need to convert the data. See, here, if it is integer type data, if you want to enter integer type data, use cint function. If you want to enter floating point values, decimal values, use cdbl function. See, cint of num1 next, cint of num2. Run the script. A value 10, B value 20. See, now it is showing correct output 30. See, you can remove here. Use conversion functions in another area, Surasri. Use conversion functions in another area.
Varitype, sir, I didn't get your question actually. Oh, okay, that's fine.
Another usage. Yeah. See, reading time only you can convert directly.
Yes, sir.
Run the script. 10, 20, 30. And one more usage. See, remove here.
Input before num1?
After reading, num1 equal to cint of num1, don't confuse. We are converting the value and storing into same variable. Anyhow, variables take latest values. Num2 equal to cint of num2. Run the script. A value 10, B value 20. See, it is showing correct output 30. Just a minute. Next, one more problem is there. If we enter valid input, then it is providing correct output. Use invalid input, it has to handle invalid inputs. A value ABC, B value XYZ. See, it is providing error message, runtime error. How to handle this situation, Nagesh?
We have to verify whether what we read the numeric or not.
Okay, here condition required, na?
Yes, sir.
Condition and is numeric function also. See, if is numeric of num1 equal to true optional, a readability point of view, you can write that one. By default, true only. And is numeric of num2, then convert and add. Else you can write any meaningful message, otherwise you can leave else part optional. MSG box invalid input.
Sir?
Ask me quick.
Sir, in this you already wrote that if is numeric of num1 is true and is numeric of num2 is true, then why do you have to again write cint of num1 plus cint of num2? Why not just num1 plus num2?
No. We are checking that value is numeric value or not. But conversion mandatory. See, observe, numeric value, number, integer, different. See, in that string, numeric value is there, but conversion mandatory. Just a minute, I will show it. Run the script. 10, 20, 30. Invalid input. Observe Saraswari. Suppose just val. Val is just variable. Enter a value. MSG box is numeric of val. MSG box var type of val. Say if I enter integer value, if I enter numbers, then what will be the two outputs, Nagesh? I am going to enter numbers only, then what will be the two outputs?
Numbers will display, sir. I mean, whatever you enter, that will display.
That will display.
In where type, in the message box,
what is the first output?
If we enter the number, that number will show, sir.
Number will show. I am displaying MSG box val. Easy numeric of val.
Sorry, sir. True.
True. Second output.
Second output.
8. We are reading 8. Blindly you can say why 8. See. 100. Easy numeric true. But var type 8. Okay, naam. Surasri.
Yes, sir.
Suppose ABC, then what are the two outputs, Sarasri? This is my input. What is the first output?
Sir, first output will be false. And the second output will be 2?
8 only.
Reading through the...
See, if it is reading or not, ABC string only.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yeah.
False, 8. So, conversion is mandatory if you read the data. Easy numeric function checks whether that inside of that value, inside of that strings, number or not. See, observe. What type of data it is? Muhammad? Val equal to 100. Tell me, is it string or integer or double or date?
String
type. Very good. You tell me, Nagesh.
It's an integer, sir.
Integer. Next. Val equal to within double quotes 100. Tell me, Surasri, second one. Is it string or integer or double or?
String.
String,
sir.
But inside numbers are there, na?
Yes, sir.
String, but numeric, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
First one, integer numeric. Second one, string numeric. Next.
Yes, sir.
Val equal to ABC. This one?
This is again string, sir.
String only. String only.
Yeah.
Okay. See, next. We discussed the two usages. One is using conditional statements. Second one using some built-in functions. Example, conversion functions, use numeric functions, etc. Next, exit statement. Exit statement. What is the purpose of exit statement? Can you tell me, Nagesh? Already we discussed this one. What is the purpose of exit statement?
So whenever condition is false, it will not execute the remaining statements of the program.
To terminate loops.
Terminate loops.
Simple. To terminate here. Don't bother about condition. To terminate loops. Okay. So I will show an example. Concentrate. It is for terminating loops. Okay. Within the loop, condition mandatory. see open order operation. Put base state. I want to open 1 to 10 orders for I equal to 1 to 10. For one increment step is optional. Default increment is 1. If it is other than 1, use step. Otherwise, optional. See, pass I as parameter. If you want to observe the data, insert wait statement. It is also optional. Next, run the script. It will open 1 to 10 records if available. If available in the database. See, 1, 2, 3, 4. See, 8th record. 9, 10. Next, see, open 11 to 20 records. Base state optional. Run the script. 11, 12, 15, observe scripting logic. Is there any errors in this scripting?
No, sir.
No error. But we are getting error. Script run error. This is runtime error, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
See, scripting logic is correct, but our database is insufficient. Suppose yesterday we executed the script, executed, but today somebody deleted that 17 to 20 records. See how to handle this situation. See here, condition required. Condition. If so and so error pop-up exists, kill the pop-up, cancel the open order dialog. See, put base state. This is base state. Write condition. If so and so error pop-up exists, then before end if exit for, terminate the for loop. Run the script. Terminated now, Muhammad.
Yes, sir.
Suppose if all orders available, it won't terminate. same. Suppose 125. 125 orders available, it won't terminate. See, 1. Every time it checks, 2. Three, four, five. All orders opened. Just a minute. Now fail it. If you want to define result, define. See, terminating loops means warning status. Warning. See, earlier inserting transaction points chapter, I used done status. Next, in scripting chapter, we used pass and fail status. This time I am going to use warning status. See, four types of result status in EFT: pass, fail, done, warning. Define that statement. Can you tell me that syntax, Nagesh?
Report event. Mic warning,
or you can use mic warning or
three.
Either 0 or pass, either 1 or fail, either 2 or done, either 3 or warning. See, 3 comma next result step name comma any meaningful message details. See, up to, concatenate, I minus 1, again concatenate, orders only exist. Why I am writing I minus 1, Surasri? Why I am writing I minus 1?
Sir, because the ith record we were not able to open. So, I minus 1 record exists.
Suppose 15th order not exist. Means 15 minus 1, 14 only exist. Okay. Run the script. Say 13. Every time it checks. Over. Loop terminated. Open result window. See, yellow warning status, observe, up to 16 orders only exist, warning. And we can use do loop also. Nagesh, instead of for loop, use do loop and terminate. Same requirement. Use do loop and terminate.
Do while.
You want while or until? While. Okay. Do while. I want to open 13 to 20 records. 13 to 20. First initialize the variable. Initialize the variable.
I equal to 13 initialize.
I equal to 13. Next.
I less than or equal to 20.
I less than or equal to 20. Okay. Next here, enter loop. Exit do. Next, one more thing also required. Increment required, na?
Yes, sir.
I equal to i plus 1. See, same requirement earlier for loop, this time do loop. Terminating do loop. See, 16th record. See, terminated. Next, use just while vend. While vend, Surasri. Logic same. While.
Yes, while and instead of. Yeah, end.
Next, exit.
Exit while.
Exit while. Say, no exit while.
Yes, sir.
Observe, if you want to terminate loops, if you want to terminate loops, use for loop or do loop, do while or do until, no exit while. Okay, na Nagesh?
Okay, sir.
Next, see terminating, see we covered using conditional statements, exit statement, built-in functions. Next, option explicit. It is error prevention mechanism. Error prevention. What is the functionality of option explicit? It forces declaration of all variables in a script so that we can avoid misspell problems. See, already we discussed this option explicit in variables chapter. Dim error prevention mechanism. Tickets, price, total. Tickets equal to 10. Price equal to 70. Next, total. Total equal to tickets into price. MSG box, total. See, here my expectation is 700. Expected 700. But it is showing 0. Why it is showing 0, Mohammed?
Because I misinterpreted a variable, sir.
Yes. See, declaration time, we used PRICE. Value assignment time, PRICE. But calculation time, we used PRIE. But it is not showing any errors. Why? VBScript VBScript supports implicit variables. See, by default variable value 0, it is calculating something into 0, 0. See, no error, no expected output. See, here use option explicit. It should be the first statement. Option explicit. Then it will show error. You can get, then you can correct it. See, variable is undefined. Next, on error resume next statement. On error resume next. Just a minute. What is on error resume next statement? If any error is there, don't stop the execution. Skip the error and continue. See, functionality of on error resume next. If any error is there, don't stop the execution. Skip the error and continue. See, functionality. If any errors, one or more, if any errors are there, skip the errors and continue execution. And continue the execution. Next, when to choose this statement, when not to choose. Suppose if there is no impact on final output, choose on error resume next. Any impact on final output, don't choose. See, when to choose. Next, when not to choose. When to choose. If any impact on, if there is no impact, if there is no impact on final output, next, when not to choose, if any impact on final output, if any impact, tell me Muhammad, what is on error resume next statement, functional purpose, next when to choose, when not to choose.
Functionality is if any errors are there, skip the errors and continue.
When to choose, and when not to choose.
When to choose, if there is no impact in the final output, then if you choose the on error. If there is a impact on the final output, then don't not to choose.
Don't choose. Okay, see. Observe. Record the navigation. add cities. Stop. Put base state. Run the script. Adding. Next, run the script on second version. In the second version, one item missing. Hyderabad item not available. Developers removed that item. Run the script. See, it is showing error na, Nagesh?
Yes, sir.
Here use on error resume next. See, if error is there, means if no item, it will skip that one. If items available, it will execute all statements. See, put base state, run the script, executing. Next, run the script on first version. In this version, Hyderabad item available. No problem. It won't skip. No error. It won't skip. Abdur Muhammad, is there any impact on final output in this example?
No, sir.
No impact. So you can use on error resume next. No impact on final output. Next, impact scenario. Suppose if any syntax errors are there, don't use this one. Any syntax errors? Say dim a comma b, a equal to 100, b equal to 200. MSG box A plus B. Syntax error is there. See, instead of equal to, I used hyphen. My expected output 300. If it is addition operation, it is showing 100. Impact on output na, Surasri?
Yes, sir.
Impact. So here don't use. Then it will show syntax error, you can correct it. Next, EFT tool feature, recovery scenarios. Say, in real time, you use VBScript features only. Recovery scenarios, limited use or no use. But interview point of view, certification exam point of view required. See, recovery scenarios. See, tool feature. What is recovery scenario? Why recovery scenarios? Next, trigger events. Next, recovery operations. Recovery operations. Next, create new recovery scenario. Next, associate recovery scenarios, one or more. Next, optional, edit recovery scenario if required. Next, delete recovery scenario if required. Say, recovery scenario is file. Extension is QRS, quick recovery scenario. Say, already we discussed, EFT is one-tier application. It stores its resources using file format on file system, physical hard disk. It doesn't have any database. It supports file format. See, so far we discussed some resources of EFT. Shared Object Repository File, TSR, extension. Next, Function Library File, VBS. Environment Variables File, XML. Next, test batch file. Surasri, what is the extension of test batch file? Nagesh. Nagesh, extension of test batch file.
Sorry, I don't remember.
MTB. Next, extension of recovery scenario file, QRS.
QRS.
Okay. See, first, what is recovery scenario? What is recovery scenario? It is a scenario makes EFT from abnormal state to normal state during execution. Why recovery scenarios? See, to make EFT from abnormal to normal state during execution, we use recovery scenarios. See, it is a scenario to handle errors during execution. Next, why recovery scenarios? To make UFT from abnormal state to normal state during execution, we use recovery scenarios. See, what is recovery scenario? Why recovery scenarios? Next, trigger events. Trigger events means happening events, trigger, ready to fire. Happening events during execution. UFT handles some types of events only, not all types of events. See, it handles four types of trigger events. What are the four types? Pop-up window, next, test run error, next, object state, Next, application crash. Application crash means hanging. See, UFT handles these four types of trigger events. Next, recovery operations. Solutions. Keyboard or mouse operation. Keyboard or mouse operation. Next, close application process. Close application process. Next, function call. Next, restart MS Windows if it is application crash. Restart MS Windows. See, these are the recovery operations. Tell me, Surasri, UFT handles four types of trigger events. What are they?
If there is a pop-up window, or test run error, or object state, or application crash.
Next, recovery operations. Mohammed Sohail, recovery operations.
So mouse or keyboard operation, then close application process, then function call, then restart MS Windows.
Good. See, next, create new recovery scenario. See, just generate script. Insert verification point. If window of flight reservation dot exist of 12, then close in order to set base state. Next, a result equal to login successful. Next, unsuccessful. Else, login unsuccessful. Cancel the login dialog. Suppose this is the script. Run the script. Valid inputs, login successful, that window also closed. Next, invalid input. See, this time it will show error pop up.
the statement, sir.
No, we didn't add. Just which statement?
Flight reservation disable button, sir. Mm-hmm. I mean, just we directly add the cancel button of login.
Yes, yes. Suppose this is the situation.
Okay.
How to use pop-up recovery scenario?
Okay.
Okay. Login cancel also there, but one interruption is there. That interruption is flight reservation pop-up. See, this is the situation. Then how to use pop-up recovery scenario for this situation? See, resources menu, recovery scenario manager, here also in this recovery scenario manager also one or two defects also there. Click on new. What happening na Nagesh? Nothing na?
Yes, sir.
Click on this new scenario icon. Click next. Select a trigger event. Our trigger event is pop-up window. That is default option. Next. Show the window. Next. Recovery operation. I am going to use keyboard or mouse operation. Clicking on that default button, that is mouse operation. See, keyboard or mouse operation. Next. Show that button with label. Next, add another recovery operation, not required. See, for one recovery, for one trigger event, you can add one or more, but most of the time, single recovery operation enough. Uncheck this option. Next, proceed to next step. Next scenario name. Suppose pop-up. If you want to write any meaningful description here, you can write, but it is optional. Next, here two options are there. Add scenario to current test. Here we can associate recovery scenarios in two ways. First one, while creating the scenario, you can associate. Next, after creating the scenario also you can associate. See, in two ways we can associate recovery scenarios. First one, while creating the scenario. Next, after creating the scenario. Next, association two levels. See, don't confuse. Two ways of association, two levels of association. Two ways means while creating the scenario, next after creating the scenario. Two levels means one is test level, another is tool level. See, add scenario to default test settings. Add scenario to default test settings. If you select the second option, then it will associate for every new test level. See, here I am not selecting any option. I can associate externally. This is internal association. Finish. Next, save. Suppose pop up TRS, QRS. QRS already there. Save. Close recovery scenario manager. Check whether that scenario associated or not. File menu, settings. We didn't associate externally. We didn't associate internally. Associate externally. How to associate? File, settings, recovery, click add icon, browse path of the scenario, add scenario, just apply. If you select set as default, what will happen, Nagesh?
It will be applicable to all tests.
Not all tests, applicable for every new test.
Every new test.
Suppose already I created 40 tests. Hello?